So me and Paul are here at Metalite, and we've got these two components. Paul, what are they?
Well, this is what I love about what we do. When you visit companies and you don't know what they're going to be making when you get there, but when you arrive, you see parts that, you know, this has a purpose in probably our everyday life. And what it is it's actually the tool for soup bowls. Okay, now this is typically a soup bowl, which we'd find in your supermarket.
Or at the bottom of my cupboard.
At the bottom of your cupboard, full or empty, it depends whether you like soup. But basically what this tool is, this is of course the female side of the tool. It's machined out of H13, it's 50 Rockwell. It is, as I say, this is the female side. Now the point of this story is, these are all manufactured here at Metalite, but they recently purchased Hypermill software from OpenMind. Now that has completely eliminated a polishing operation. So this bore in here has to be to a certain standard on its surface finish.
Yeah.
And previously they were machining it, it's all been interpolated machined, and they were then having to take the part and get it polished. But now they don't do any of that because the programming or the CAM solution has provided the strategy or the cycle to machine this and create just a brilliant
That's
surface
absolutely
finish.
Absolutely amazing that they've actually managed to completely delete basically another application and are able to do that. You don't have to move it off the machine, it's in the Hypermill. And Lee was saying that he invested in Hypermill, what, about a year ago. And what are the benefits that he's seen? Obviously, this is one of them, isn't it?
This is one of them. The programming side, they've recently installed a Quasar automation cell from the engineering technology group. And they've actually got virtual machine. They've just opted for that module with it as well. Now, that basically means for them that, well, it speeds up a lot of the processes. It means that they have all the kinematics of the machine, so they will avoid collisions. There's no issues with that. And it basically takes them to the next level when they're looking to manufacture complex parts, but program them very quickly and effectively using a CAM solution. Now, bear in mind that this particular application here, all over 10 microns.
That's okay? Unbelievable. Yep. And the fact that they can do that, because obviously you think of polishing, it's a completely different application to CNC milling, CNC turning. And so whether you do it in-house or out-of-house, it's going to cost you a little bit more, isn't it? And to have that available in the Hypermill software, it's just incredible.
It's the time, but it's also the fact that I don't know whether you can make a mistake when you're polishing, but what I do know is if you're using, you know, good strategies, machining strategies, when you've got the finished part done in one hit, you're not going to introduce the possibility of having an accident or an error somewhere else. So it's a really good endorsement and a testimony, really, on what Hypermill software can
do
to improve machining.
And another fact is, once someone's trained on Hypermill, if you do the polishing, someone's going to be trained on the polishing, then there's another CNC miller that has to be trained on the mill. So you basically need two people. This puts out not just the polishing, but another trained engineer to do it. So you've got his salary on top of that to do this polishing. So it's all done in one. That's fantastic.
Totally. And what we're going to do is I'm going to actually challenge the audience and ask them what they think is the machining time of this this male side of the part. Now, bearing in mind you've got all the interpolation, the facing, all of
the
support holes,
well,
the chamfering, drilling, threading. Quite a lot of work on here. H13, pretty hard material, but all done on one of their Quasar machines. So how long do you think it took to machine this side? Put your comments on the YouTube channel or on whatever platform you're watching this on.